Another important concept that we should discuss here is the difference between small data and big data. Small data represent what we used to understand as data. Data that I can't manage in my computer, I can open, for example, a spreadsheet, I can see, but it's very different from big data. And better to understand small data, let's first explain what exactly is big data. We can explain big data by V letters, yes, and V are the letter that starts some important concepts on big data. Here are two important concepts. Big data comes in very big volumes. And why is that? What is happening? Because now we have internet, we have smartphones, we have social medias, we have lots of different ways to produce data in very big volumes. 90% of today's data has been created in just the last 2 years. We produce quinquillions of bytes of data every day. The volumes of this kind of data are very big. Imagine how many data Google, for example, have to manage just looking to the search page that we have. Millions of searches during a day. How much data this search creates. This is the concept of volume. But at the same time, velocity, the data comes in a speed very fast. For example, in 60 seconds, imagine how many movies are creating in YouTube. In 60 seconds, imagine how many photos are posted in Instagram, how many videos are uploading to YouTube, and how many emails are exchanging. And the velocity of those data are increasing day by day by day because the infrastructure that we have today with every device connected each other using internet, yes, and using clouds to support all this data to exchange. Then those are the two first V's of big data, volume and velocity. The other two V's, and maybe we have 3, 4, 5, it doesn't matter how many, but at least the first three were volume, velocity and variety. And what is variety? Variety is, as I told you, the unstructured data. Because the data is not only numbers right now. The data could be text, the data is images, the data is video. The majority of the data nowadays created are on videos or on images. And imagine that how many data are now available to us, but in a different format. And for that reason, we usually say that big data means unstructured data with a variety of kind of data. And one of a new V's that we brought to the big data concept is veracity, because it's so important. In this world of deep fakes, in this world of so many information, we have to understand who was responsible, who created that data. Is a data that I can trust or not? That veracity, it's a very new V that was bring to the concept of the data, but is very important. Then, as I said, what's the difference between big data and small data? If we are dealing with only spreadsheets or files in a database with numbers and some strings, for example, now this is very old data that we used to deal with it from years, and we consider this is small data, or we don't use the small word. This is data and very important, but it's data. But the opposite of this is the big data that comes in volume, that comes in velocity, that comes in a variety, and we need to assure the veracity of that data. If we really combine all of this data and can manage all this kind of data, this is big data, opposite to the small data, which are the normal kind of data that we have in our computers, laptops, and or even data centers with some servers storing and manage this kind of data. Big data needs for sure lots of storage, lots of computers, clusters of computers to manage this kind of data, but bringing us lots of information that we can use to get value with AI.